Hello, welcome to Saws UK's test shop. My name is Alan Peatfield. This is our model HD620 SAF bandsaw. I'll go through all the salient features of this machine with you. It has capacity of 620 by 320 for beam work like we have in here, but also we can cut 500 diameter rounds. The blade in this case is 41mm. Cheaper machines only use a 34mm blade. There's a big difference between using a 41mm blade and a 34mm blade. Over here we have the downfeed sensitivity device. Basically, this means that when a machine is cutting the work, this takes over and monitors the blade cutting through the work and will slow it down if necessary, if you're overfeeding it by mistake, for instance. Here we have carbide tip blades. There's a carbide tip both ends here on both sides of the blade, and it's repeated down that end as well. Backed up by steel roller bearings, two here and two around the other side, same the other end again. This is our swarf brush, driven by a gearbox and a motor. Normally you only see this on very, very expensive machines. It's standard on this machine. This is the swarf collector. We remove this for cleaning each day as of when required. And underneath we have a coolant tank, which also can be cleaned out periodically. Okay, from this side of the machine we have the guide arm adjustment. We just undo those jacquard handles on both guide arms and we can move them in and out depending on the size of the material. Down here there is a block which can be moved out of the way. That block is to reference the machine at 0 degrees or 90, whichever way you want to call it. This is the adjustment for the bow height above the job, so you can set it so it's just above the job, save time. There's a scale there for that. The motor and gearbox speak for themselves. It's a huge gearbox on here, and the motor is 5.5 horsepower. Okay, mitering on the machine is easy. There's a digital readout up here. I'll show you that later. You just unclamp the machine like this with a handle, and you can go right round to 60 degrees to the left, like that, if you want 60 degrees. And you can move the vise across like this, and you can go right round to 60 degrees like that and lock it off. This is the digital readout for the mitering. As you can see, it's set at 45 degrees at the moment. You can actually re-zero that, re-reference that with the reference block that I showed you on the back of the machine earlier. 45 degrees, going right up to 60 degrees, and we can do that both ways. Okay, blade tensioning, obviously done up with this handle here. There are Belville spring washers here which collapse at a given rate, irrespective of the length of the blade. As the tension is correct, it makes the switch here. You can actually hear an audible click with that switch, and then at that point the machine will work. You can start the machine and run it. Should the blade break, obviously this comes away and the machine stops. Okay, this is the emergency stop switch. Once you've pressed that down, you'll need to reset it by pressing that safety switch. Then the machine will be ready to use again. Switch here for automatic, that means that the machine will go down, do the cut and pop back up again. Also, it will clamp the work at the same time, automatically. But you can have it in the manual position for clamping manually and for going down and doing a cut, and that way the machine will stop at the bottom if you so wish to leave the machine in the bottom position. You can obviously raise the machine by pressing this button here. The blade speed is controlled here and it appears on a digital readout here. Over here we have the downfeed rate, that is the bow descent rate, which is quite a nice micro adjustment here. It won't come crashing down on the job. I'll just switch on the hydraulics now so you can see the digital readout. Obviously it's reading zero because we haven't started the motor. But the top speed for the blade is 90 meters a minute, which is more than enough for kind of materials that the machine's designed for. For instance, on structural steels, you'll be running around 70 to 80 meters per minute. Control panel here that will swivel right round to the back of the machine if necessary, so that you can do repetition pass operating the machine from behind. Here we have the pivot point of the machine, which is lower than normal. That is to enable the blade to cut through the work at an angle when you reach the bottom. That means you don't have too many teeth in contact with the work. A lot of machines actually finish up parallel here, which means that when you're cutting flats at box section or flat plane, you've got too many teeth in contact with the work. It slows the machine down and causes all sorts of problems. With the blades, we do a structural blade which has less of a clearance angle on the back to give it more support. An extra set so that when you're cutting materials like this which have stress in them, it doesn't pinch the blade and jam in the cut. If you're one of those people who doesn't like coolant all over the floor, which is obviously will happen with cutting pieces like this and box sections, etc., it's inevitable, you can go for our optional vegetable oil spray kit, which means if you put tiny little bits of highly lubristic vegetable oil on the blade and it won't end up on the floor, you won't actually see it. It's well worth putting on this kind of machine. Okay, I'm now going to do a test cut on this beam.